Shri Gurubhyo Namaha children, we welcome you for our online teaching academy Ekalaiva. Today we are going to continue with 12th standard state board physics chapter number 6 ray optics. Today we are going to discuss on mirror equation. Now I am going to derive the mirror equation with respect to a concave mirror. So this mirror equation, it establishes the relation between object distance, image distance and the focal length of a mirror. So let us derive the mirror equation. Now this is the ray diagram. To understand the mirror equation, this is with respect to a concave mirror. Now here is an object. AB is the object. Now the object is kept beyond C. Now this is center of curvature and here is the principal focus. So the object is kept beyond C. Okay, so if the object is beyond C, the image will be formed between C and F. So let us derive an equation for this image with respect to object distance, image distance and focal length. Now here I am going to consider three paraaxial rays. So this is the first ray, this is the second ray and this is the third ray. So I am going to apply the rules. Now I have already described you about the rules that has to be followed in the image formation. So here I have taken the first ray here. Now this is the first ray. This ray is parallel to the principal axis. Now this ray meets at point D, gets reflected. After reflection it passes through the principal focus. So this is the first paraaxial ray. Then the second ray is here. Now this ray is incident at point that is which is considered to be the pole and it is getting reflected. So this is the second paraaxial ray. And the third one, of course, now this is the ray that passes through the center of curvature, incident at point E on the mirror, and it is reflected back. It retraces its path. Now all these three rays, okay, they meet at this point. Now this ray passing through the principal focus, it passes through here, then it is incident at pole, it is getting reflected, and this is passing through the center of curvature, it retraces its path. So all these three rays, they meet at this point when I draw a perpendicular. So this is nothing but the position where the image is formed. Okay, so now I am going to derive the mirror equation based on this. So to start with, I am going to apply the laws of reflection. So as per the laws of reflection, now we know the first law of reflection as the angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection. Now here I am going to consider this angle of this ray where the angle of incidence is at P. I am going to consider this triangle. So as per the law of reflection, the angle of incidence, the angle of incidence, angle B P A. Now where is this angle? Here, B P A. So this angle, okay, angle B P A is equal to the angle of reflection. So what is the angle of reflection? It is B dash P A dash. Now here this is the reflected angle, right? So this is B dash P A dash. Now this is with respect to the angle of, I mean the laws of reflection. Now I'm going to consider once again the triangles. What are the triangles I'm going to consider here? The triangles B P A and triangle B dash P A dash. Okay, so both these triangles are similar. Okay, so what were the triangles? Now here B P A and here B dash P A dash. So these two triangles are similar triangles. So hence we can write A dash B dash by AB. So here this is the image. So A dash B dash by this value, this is the object. So A dash B dash by AB is equal to this distance P A dash. Now this is the distance at which the object is found. This is the distance of the object from the pole. So P A dash by P A. Now this is the image distance. P A is the, sorry, object distance. P A dash is the image distance. So A dash B dash by A B is equal to P A dash by P A. Now let us consider this as equation 1. Okay, now similar triangles, there are two more triangles like this. So what are the triangles? Let me write here. So the triangles, now I'm going to consider two more triangles, which is here. Now here the triangle D P F dash. Now here this is principal focus. So D P F. So this is one triangle and here B dash A dash F. So this triangle and this triangle, they are also similar. So the triangles, what are the triangles? D P F and triangle B dash A dash F. Okay, so they are also similar. So from those triangles again I can write A dash B dash by, now this distance A dash B dash, which is equal, naturally this is a curve, but here you can consider almost to be a straight line. Okay, because the angle is very small, so I can consider this to be a straight line. So in that case this distance is taken. So A dash B dash by PD is equal to, now what is this distance? Now here this is A dash F, A dash F by this distance. This distance is PF. So this is equation 2. Is it clear? So these are the two equations that we got from the similar triangles. Now look at this equation, children. Now here A dash B dash by PD is equal to A dash F by PF. Now in this, look at the diagram. Now this PD is almost equal to AB. Now here look at this distance. Now this is equal to this. So instead of PD, as PD is equal to AB, the above equation becomes, the above equation becomes, let me substitute for PD as AB. So here again I will have this equation as A dash B dash by AB is equal to A dash F by PF. Okay, so this is equation 3. So let us see these two equations, children. Now equation 1, equation 3, they have similar terms on the left side. So I can compare these two equations. So from equation 1 and 3, I can write P A dash by P A is equal to A dash F by P F. Hope you are following it. I have taken equation 1, equation 3. Now from this equation 1 and equation 3, P A dash by P A is equal to A dash F by P F. Hope you are following this step. Now let us go back to the diagram about this A dash F. Now this is the distance. Now here the distance between principal focus and the image. Now which is taken as A dash F. So what is this value of A dash F? I can write this A dash F as P A dash minus P F. So as A dash F is equal to P A dash minus P F. Okay. Now again, the above equation can be written as the above equation becomes substitute A dash F as P A dash minus P F. So I will substitute in this equation P A dash by P A is equal to P A dash minus P F by P F. So this is equation 4. Now I am going to apply the sign conventions for all the distances. So applying sign conventions for various distances. Now I am going to substitute. Now what is P A dash? Look at the diagram once again. Now this P A dash is nothing but the image distance, that is the distance of the image from the pole. So what is P A dash, children? P A dash is minus V. Okay, then what is P A? Now P A is this distance. Okay, so this is nothing but the object distance of the object from the pole. So this P A is minus U. Okay, and I need to substitute the value of P F. Okay, so go back to the diagram. What is P F? P F is nothing but the focal length. So the value of P F is nothing but minus F. Now here all the values, they take a negative sign. So what is the reason why they have a negative sign here? According to the Cartesian convention, whatever values that are measured to the left side of the pole, now all these values are to the left side of the pole because we consider the direction of incident light to be from left to right. But all the values we measure are from right to left, which is considered to be the direction opposite to the direction of incident light. So this is the direction of incident according to the sign convention. Hope you remember the rule. Okay, so all the values will have a negative sign. Now substitute all these values in this equation 4. So I'm going to substitute, right? So what is P A dash? P A dash is minus V. P A is minus U is equal to, what is again P A dash? Again it is minus V minus P F is minus F. So it is minus F here divided by P F. P F is again minus F. Okay, so simplifying the above equation, I have V by U equal to V minus F by F. Okay, or I can also write this equation as V by U equal to V by F minus F by F. Now this becomes 1. So I can write this as minus 1. Now divide the equation, dividing by V. Now this equation you divide it by V. So in that case, now divide by V, V and V gets cancelled. So I have 1 by U is equal to, now here also divide by V. So again V, V gets cancelled. I have 1 by F minus 1 by V. Now rearrange this equation. When I rearrange this equation, bring this minus 1 by V to the other side, left side. I have 1 by U plus 1 by V is equal to 1 by F. So this is the mirror equation which relates object distance, image distance and the focal length. So this is nothing but you call it as mirror equation. Very, very important equation as far as mirrors are concerned, spherical mirrors are concerned. Okay ma? Let us now look at lateral magnification in spherical mirrors. So what is lateral magnification? Now this is the definition, children. Lateral magnification is defined as the ratio of height of the image to the height of the object. Now where is the image, where is the object here? Now this is the object and this is the image. Now the heights which are perpendicular to the principal axis, now you measure the ratio of the height of the object with respect to the height of the image, which is represented as lateral magnification, and it is represented by M. Okay, so lateral magnification M is equal to height of the image by height of the object. Height of the object. Now this is equal to, now let us take the height of the image as h dash and height of the object to be h. So in that case, magnification M will be h dash by h. Okay, now I'm going to take this equation 1 which we took from this ray diagram while forming the mirror equation. So this is the first equation. Let me take this equation once again. A dash B dash by AB is equal to PA dash by PA. Now I'm going to substitute the values of distances for this equation. Now let us take this A dash B dash. So what is A dash B dash here? A dash B dash is nothing but the height of the image, whereas AB is nothing but the height of the object. So substitute. Now here with respect to proper sign convention, we are going to substitute the value. Now here this A dash B dash is below the principal axis. Now AB is above the principal axis. So when I substitute the value of A dash B dash, I should have a negative sign here. So here A dash B dash, A dash B dash is minus H dash divided by AB is above the principal axis. So here this is H. Okay, on to the right side I have P A dash. Now P A dash is nothing but the image distance and P A is nothing but the object distance. Both will have a negative sign. So I have P A dash as minus V and P A as minus U. On simplifying this equation, we have we have the formula for magnification as M is equal to H dash by H is equal to minus v by u. So this is the formula for magnification. Now we can also have the formula for magnification using the mirror formula. So here are the formulas based on the mirror formula for magnification, as m is equal to h dash by h. Now this is equal to f minus v by f, or I can also have one more formula as f by f minus u. So these are also the formulas for magnification. Hope you are able to understand the concept very clearly, children. See you in our next video. To receive our online lessons, please press the subscribe button and you will be receiving our latest updates. Thank you, children.